potato box kick the bucket.
Can you keep it for a second? You can put it inside. You finna eat inside? Yeah, go up. You can take it inside because all the flies out here.
I get it. Thanks.
The potato box has finally kicked the bucket. That one is still trying to hang in there, but this one has kicked the bucket. And as I was picking, I started to see some baby potatoes. I got some yellow ones and I got some purple ones that didn't quite make it. I'd already picked some black eyed peas. But, so I just decided I'm just gonna come out here and dig and dig and dig and see what I got. I grew a purple potato. Let's see what's in here. Small potato. Oh, here go another one. It looked like something. Oh, I thought I saw something. Oh, wow. This box had a hard time this year, but it still produced some potatoes. Look like mostly purple potatoes, but I know I had some yellow ones in here somewhere, but that the one that was yellow looked like it was the top of the plant looked like it was getting a disease on it. So I don't know if it had enough time to actually produce any yellow potatoes under here. Yeah, mostly purples, which I'm still happy about. They're a nice little size. This is my second year attempting potatoes. Last year it was a dud. This year I'm definitely way happier about it. Yeah, all the yellow potatoes are real tiny. And that plant top was pretty much done for before it even really got started. I mean, they were nice little tops, but they were not as big as they should have gotten and didn't last as long. That's a nice size. So I'm trying to grow on this root bottom. section finally came back in, and I found another one as I was digging. I know I ain't digging thoroughly, but I'm just trying to see. Uh-oh, I pulled another one. All right, little purple potatoes. I'm a little proud of the purple potatoes. I don't know if that's it, but let me see what I got. So this is what happens every time I try to get down close to the ground. It shows no network connection. But we got this out of the potato bed. That. No, Gizmo, stay back. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Some tiny ones don't count, but still. Mostly purple potatoes this year. I still got that whole other side to do. I'm gonna see if it'll last a little longer, because the side that I tore down just now is done for. I'm gonna put garlic on that side. But I am just amazed by how the garden just overflows and does so good. And I can't help but think of how God said all that God did all this for us. I mean, it just looks so good and everything works so well together. This is I love being out here. All the flowers pollinating, just literally watching everything, this life cycle right in front of your eyes. I mean, with all the craziness that's going on in the world today, this right here bring me joy. So I am very thankful to be able to see this garden do as well as it's doing. And I know some people got way bigger, but I enjoy watching this kind of the mason bees go in and out of the flowers, and then coming out the next day and seeing the fruit or the vegetable hanging from the very flower that I watched a mason bee pollinate the day before, just letting me know that they're doing their job, and that this design of, you know, God's design is just flawless. We can try to replicate this all we want, but we'll never be able to get it as perfect as God set it up to be. So here, looking at this garden, this little area, the first couple videos, this area was as bare as this ground right here. It was just hard and clay and ugly, and I was determined to get this area to be plush and able to allow something to grow in it. And I prayed about this area. I'm not even gonna lie. I pray about my garden, because I don't want anything to destroy it. But look at that. And they don't bother me. Like, I know a lot of people, but these bees don't bother me. I don't bother them, and they don't bother me. They just come, pollinate, and go ahead about their business. So I just watch them go from flower to flower and fly on about their business. And they don't bother the dogs either. I think that's the best part about it, that, you know, the dogs can be out here laying right next to a flower. Look, right next to a flower with her itchy self. And the bees can be literally right next to them and not bother them. That's good. I thought about attempting to house some bees in a bee house, but I would want these kind of bees, these black mason bees. They kind of loner bees. I mean, it's like one or two of them that go back to their nest and have baby, you know, whatever, however they lay their eggs and stuff like that. And they don't have like a big swarm, but those honeybees, they have a swarm. And so you can put up like a bee house or something like that, but you can't keep certain bees out that I know of. So I put up a little bee house, just, you know, just experimenting. But it wasn't, you know, I wasn't like, I can keep the bees that I don't want in there. So the wasps, they came before these black mason bees. I want a home for the mason bees because they doing all the work in the garden. And, you know, I'd rather for them to have somewhere to stay nearby. And they don't swarm, so you don't have to worry about a big swarm of them. You walk underneath their nest and they trying to sting you and attack you. You don't have to worry about that with the mason bees. But you do have to worry about that with wasps and some honeybees. I like the honeybees, but I would love to have some honey, but you need a field or somewhere exclusive that you're doing honeybees to be able to house them, because they need space. Their population gets big. But so I was just checking on stuff and replanting. The cantaloupe in here is doing good. I don't know if you can see the cantaloupe in there. Let me see if I can get low without the connection going out. But there's a cantaloupe in there. It's still kind of green, but it's starting to get its like, what is it, like a tan color stripes on it, and look like wool stitching. It's starting to get that.